Hey YouTube, it's your girl Yona Marie, and today I want to talk about how to get radio station airplay for free.
Yona Marie Music, create with me.
So, you might hear people saying that radio is dead. Spotify's out, Apple Music is out, nobody's listening to the radio, nobody's discovering new music from the radio. That's done, that's dead. I don't need to pay attention to radio promotion when I release my new songs. That's a lie. Now, I see where they're coming from because Spotify and them are taking over, sure. But as an indie artist, you want to get every opportunity you can to get heard because it's hard to get heard on Spotify. It's hard to get heard on Pandora. It's hard to get chosen for these editorial playlists. So you need to make sure you're checking every option when it comes to marketing and promotion. Now, the good thing about radio stations that are popping up now is that you can submit yourself. You don't have to rely on a label. You don't have to make $5,000 and put that in your budget for radio promotion. Because, yeah, that's how major labels still do it. That's how some independent labels do it. But you have some opportunities to get heard without even having to set up a budget for it. Because some radio stations are actively looking for unsigned music artists to play. One of the cool things about getting play on the radio is that you can get into rotation for a long period of time. Especially if you have an EP, if you have an album versus having a single. You have a chance to just get steady rotation. So I don't need to get into it too much, but just make sure you have professional quality music that has been mixed and mastered, that sounds appealing, that people will want to accept. You want the music directors to listen to it and be like, wow, we just have to add this to our playlist because this is fire. This is what our audience will want to hear right now. If that's not what you're making yet, just bookmark this video, come back to it later. So in today's music world, a lot of us are independent. We're making our own music. We're doing it from home. We don't have a label. We don't have a big marketing engine with a huge budget that's just ready to help us with thousands of dollars so we can get the spins to all our favorite local channels. We don't have that, but we do have an opportunity to submit to these three types of stations that I do want to talk about and share with you today. So the first one is college radio station. It's really simple to get onto a college radio station and to get into rotation, more importantly, because you don't want to just get one play. You want to get your song into rotation for several plays. You want to rack up those listens. You want to rack up possible chances to get heard and rack up royalties at the same time, because college radio stations do pay royalties. That's right. College stations do pay royalties. Now, don't expect millions of dollars because, you know, it's just not gonna happen for you, but maybe you can make a few hundred. So the key to getting the college radio music directors to accept you, these music directors will be kids. They will be kids that are on staff. They have volunteered to be a part of the college radio staff. So make sure you can connect with these kids. I mean, make sure you're talking in a language that they understand you. Most likely it will be email. It's a good idea to also send physical submissions, like your CDs if possible, because they'll be more inclined to open your stuff up if you're sending a physical package of your CD. Like, they're gonna be like, oh wow, we have to listen to this. You most likely have to playlist it for sure, like, especially if it's good. Sending singles has worked for me before with college radio stations, but they really love to get a variety of your tracks, like something that has at least 5-10 tracks on it for them to choose. Maybe take all of your music and put it in a rotation. But the more, the merrier. Now, the only downside to college radio submissions is they just might not respond to you. Some colleges don't have it together that semester. You know, recently with the pandemic, I had a lower amount of successful submissions to colleges because colleges were like out of whack with the pandemic. The world was out of whack. So of course they didn't prioritize having, you know, the radio staff listening to submissions on point one time all the time, because we were all worried, you know, we're still all worried about the health of the world right now. So that slid down on their to-do list. They probably weren't able to open everybody's email, maybe not even open everybody's package. So don't just expect for you to 100% get a chance of getting heard. Secondly, similar to college radio stations, you might have heard of community radio stations. One thing is, make sure you read, like, I can't stress this enough, make sure you read, like, the fine print when it comes to submission guidelines for college radio station and for community radio station, because a lot of them have different guidelines. They expect things differently. Like, one site might say, I need to get this on the form only, like, don't email us anything. Another site might say, don't send like an attachment. Like, we don't want your attachments. Like, if you send an attachment, we're going to automatically delete it because we won't have enough room in our inbox. Like, each station will have very specific rules and you need to follow them very specifically every time. Not to mention that a lot of people got wind of all these stations that are accepted submissions. They was just like, oh, I'm going to add this to my email blast. I don't want to submit to every radio station one at a time. I'm just going to blast them all to death with my very unpersonalized blast that I didn't put much thought or effort to at all. So a lot of those get ignored. A lot of these stations get very annoyed when they get added to a PR list like that. And they would just block you. They will block you and never hear from you again and be glad. Like, it don't even matter if your music was amazing. They're just tired of hearing the wrong thing or tired of hearing the wrong genre, getting music sent the wrong way, people sending the wrong information in the email. Please, the first thing you need to do is read the very specific instruction for that very specific radio station. I promise you will be rewarded much more if you follow their directions. I've been on the opposite end, accepting submissions, and it's super annoying when like a million people do things the wrong way when you're trying to help them and they sending you the wrong thing. You're very tempted to be like, oh, I'm just gonna ignore this. Also, with community stations, it's good to send a wide variety of styles. Like, don't limit yourself to just sending one of your CDs. Maybe you have an old CD that was more folksy, and then you have a newer CD that's more country. And then you had a little bit of pop on one of your singles. They want to hear all of it because community stations have a lot to cover to reach their community. They try to cover many genres for the most part. I mean, you might find something that's specific to rock or something that's specific to urban music, but community stations generally cover everything. So the more variety you can give them, the more chances you have of getting placed into rotation and then played over and over and over. Now, something I do see with community stations is that some of them won't take mainstream sounding music. Like, while college stations would love to hear something that they can hear on the radio from you, community stations might be, you know, looking for a unique sound. They don't want to play stuff that's on the radio because their unique edge is giving you, you know, that underground sound that's not even present in today's pop culture. So if you have something unique to give, if you have very experimental music that you want to share on the radio, your chance is with community radio stations. Now, the third type of station is similar to community stations. It's just internet radio stations in general, which I like to see as an internet community, but they don't base themselves on a specific locale when it comes to their community. It's more about the genre, the style, the message, or feel, a mood. So there are way more of these, unlike community stations and college radio stations that are very location specific, local business owners that have the licensing and everything for that. It's way easier to create an internet radio station. So the rules are very similar. Like I said, they usually follow a specific style. So you want to stay in line with the style they're accepting. You want to still follow their rules. You want to communicate well. You want to send them a wide variety of your material, possibly. And these are the type of radio stations that are most likely to accept people and most likely to check their inbox the most because they're doing it for the love of music. People who just love doing this for fun, they might not be even getting that much profit. Which brings me to the downside, because I've had the most success with just general internet radio stations. But like I said, there are so many of them. They're like too many. So a lot of them you can get accepted by and you'll be excited. You'll be like, oh, I'm in rotation with this radio station. And then the reality of the matter is the only person that's listening to that radio station is the owner of the radio station. And props to them for just being in love with their craft, doing what they do. But a lot of these internet radio stations do not know how to build an audience. And they don't have the audience that the community radio station would already have, especially the college radio station would already have. It will be up to you to doing your due diligence to figure out if the radio station that you found has a big enough audience that you would want to submit to. So you're probably thinking to yourself, okay, thank you for getting me hyped for all the radio stations I can get linked to. But where are these stations? How do I find these stations? What's the next step? What you going to link me to? What product you got that's about to show me the list? Well, I just want to show you exactly how I look for these stations myself. I have no product. I have no list. I'm just going to show you my method. Now, my method does require you to work. So if you don't want to put in the work, if you don't want to research, if you don't have time to invest, maybe you should go look for a company that can do this for you and just hope that they're doing it a legit way. But if you want to take the time yourself, put in a few minutes a day to send radio stations your single the way I have done before and I have had success with before, then let's go through these steps. Let's talk about my Google hack. So the first one I do that's very general. is send music submissions in quotation marks. So go to Google, open Google right now, type in send music submissions. So what you'll find is a few sites that'll have like a list of blogs or radio stations or opportunities for you to submit to. But what you wanna look for are results that look like radio stations. A lot of these places, like their email inbox is full, like it's too full for them. Now, if you go to a submissions page, sometimes the submissions page won't show you what genre that they're accepting because they expect you to already be a fan of that radio station. They don't expect you to be doing this Google hack that I'm sharing with you right now. So let's act like I didn't share that hack with you. Check out their programming. Go to their about. See what they're playing. See what their programs are. See who their DJs are. Because the last thing you want to do is submit your music and it's not related to what they're doing at all. Like, you're really probably just going to irritate a DJ. Like, you don't want to be out here irritating people while you're promoting your music, okay? So this is an example. I will say that when I did my submissions, I didn't do physical submissions. So I had small success with not sending out physical submissions, just doing emails. I wasn't fully committed to doing the physical because I was broke, okay? But hopefully you got more money than me in this process. So play around with the phrases that you put in. I have like several phrases I use, but I want you to get unique, get creative, get specific to your genre and see what works for you. Now, of course, you want to be careful. You want to do your work. You want to do your research when you're looking at these websites to make sure you're sending your music to a legitimate company. You don't want to just be sending your music all willy-nilly. I know us as independent artists, we just want to take any opportunity as it comes. You will run into radio stations that say they are accepting submissions for a fee. Now, I personally don't do radio play for a fee because there are certain marketing outlets that will work well and that are very worth the money. But with radio, I'm not about to pay to get played. So do be prepared to sift through a lot of mess. You're gonna find great opportunities. You're gonna find scammy looking opportunities. You're gonna find site links that are broken. You're gonna find very old websites. You're gonna find a lot of broken forms. You're just gonna have to put in the research. So I just suggest try out new things. See where it takes you. I think this is a great starting point for independent artists that aren't getting a lot of shine right now. They want to learn some things about the music industry. Talking with music directors, sometimes you can get on the phone with these people. Sometimes you can meet them in person if it's a community that you're a part of locally already. It's a really great experience for you. So I do not want you to miss out on this opportunity if it's something that's interesting you. I will be back with more tips in the future. Small plug, check out Band of Pockets, Wish You Could Be Someone Else on Spotify. It's a great collection of musicians from across the world making good music. I am a singer that's a part of that band, so I would love it if you could check out the music. You will love this music, okay? It's amazing, and I'm so happy to be a part of the Band of Pockets. Go to YonaMarieMusic.com for more music tips, more promotional tips. So I will see y'all in the next video.